Hey guys, what's happening? Now, I'm somebody who's curious to know why Ahmadi Dad did what he did. You know, the purpose of going through the debates. I have an idea, but this question was asked at a question and answer session. And let's see how he responds to it. Let's hear it from the horse's mouth.
Is it right to spread Islam by debates, dialogues? Why Christians do not ask Muslims to debate?
Christians are supposed to debate.
You see, the questioner is absolutely ignorant, totally ignorant in what he's asking. Is the I have debated now with six Americans.
Okay.
And the Americans have been coming to me. I didn't come here to America looking for them. Six Americans. I named them. Professor Simpkins of Johnson Bible College. He came to South Africa to debate with me. Josh McDowell came to South Africa to debate with me. Dr. Floyd E. Clark from Johnson Bible College, he came to England to debate with me. That's three, isn't it? Four. Jimmy Swaggart, four. Anish Roche from what you call Mobile, Alabama. He came to debate with me in England. Five, six, I counted some six. You know, somebody was asking me yesterday, and one, they came to my mind, six Americans. Oh yes, thank you very much. This Douglas we are talking about just now. I just forgot what happened yesterday. So I didn't go looking for Douglas. I didn't go looking for Jimmy Swaggart. I didn't go looking for any one of these. They are raising the dust in the world. There are at the moment, out of the world, 70,000 missionaries, evangelists, crusaders. 60% are Americans. 42,000 Americans are raising the dust throughout the world. What are you talking about? We debating with them. They are raising the dust in Pakistan. They have converted more Pakistanis into Christianity since independence than in the previous 50 years of British, 100 years of British rule. They have converted more Bangladeshis into Christianity since independence than the previous 100 years of British rule. They have converted 15 million Indonesians into Christianity. There are 35,000 full-time evangelists, crusaders in Africa involved at the moment. What are you talking about? Debating, debating. They are raising the dust. They are knocking at your door. And you are such a fool, you don't know what's going on. Unless, you know, hypocrites. I meet hypocrites here in your country. A doctor tells me, he takes me at the last trip of mine, somewhere near Detroit, Ann Arbor. Ann Arbor, is that a place like that? Yes, yes. He takes me home, some 20, 30 miles away. And in the car he's telling me, he says, you know, what, you try interfering with these Christians? Why don't you leave them alone? I says, you know, you are such a fool. I said, do you read the Quran? You know, one third of the Quran is addressed to Jews and Christians. Do you know that? One third of the Quran is addressed to Jews and Christians. If it is not relevant, I said, take it out and put it in a museum. Those pieces, one third, out. What are you wasting time with it? What are you making your children to read it? What for? But he says, look, no Christian interferes with us. I said, no. I said, don't the Jehovah's Witness come to your home? He said, no. Okay. You know whether they knock at your doors or not. I go to his house, I sleep in the house. Next morning he goes up early, he says, look, I'll come back a little later. You can have your breakfast in the meantime. I said, right. After breakfast, I'm sitting in the sitting room. Are you listening or are you talking? This gentleman here, look. Are you listening or you want to have a discussion now?
I was having discussion.
But this is not the time. You are
talk.
See, they ask questions and they start having discussions.
I didn't.
No, no, well, you had that spirit behind you. However, look, so sitting in his sitting room, I'm watching his library, and from the color of books I can make out whether they are Jehovah's Witnesses, publication, Watchtower. So I see a book there, the color, I recognize color. They have a specialized type of coloring for their books. So I take the book, Paradise Lost and Paradise Regained, title of the book. So I read, I'm a Jehovah's Witness. So when he comes, I'm asking his wife before he came, I says, Ben, sister, where did you get this from? He said, no, some Jehovah's Witness came and my husband bought it for $5. So when he came, I said, look, how did this come here in your library? No, liars, liars, hypocrites. There's something gone wrong with you. You got this in your library and you say you don't know how it comes there. He come by, Holy Ghost brought it there and put it there. This is the sickness. You see, I said, look, get rid of this emasculation. You know, you are already emasculated people. Come out of that. You know, stand up for your rights, the people, help the people, and inshallah, if you can help the people, you'll be helping yourself.
Okay, so a little bit of a different answer than what I was expecting, but it's really just clear that Ahmadinejad, he is like, I actually don't go out and look for these debates. This is not something that I'm doing, traveling around the world and looking for debates. People are actually coming to me. So, you know, and he addressed it in the way only Ahmadinejad could address it, just very blunt and straightforward. He says, okay, you know, you're asking like this ignorant question. And, you know, even when he was giving the answer, the guy wasn't really listening because I guess he kind of flipped his question. Ahmadinejad flipped his question upside down on his head and it was like, oh, okay, I guess not. And, you know, that's a big thing, too. It's like, oh, why don't you, leave them alone and whatnot. And I say if one group of religious people are free to share their religion, you know, come knocking at your door and whatever, all groups of religion should be free to share their religion, you know. And I think that's really the best way, just to be fair, when it comes to religious discussion and each religion having an opportunity to be shared. You know, when the moment people think, I think Islam, sometimes they kind of just get on the defensive and say, whoa, you're pushing that kind of too much. But again, at the same time, other religions also pushing their religion. So everybody, I think, should be free to push their religion, debate about it, share about it, and everybody should also be open to listening or not listening. It's really your choice. But I think in this case, Ahmadinejad was judged pretty unfairly, and he was sort of labeled as somebody that was doing the bad thing when he wasn't really the one going out and looking for those particular debates. And I do have to say, even if he was the one going out and looking for the debates, going out and knocking on people's door and sharing information, okay, great. You know, other religions do that, so I don't see that it would be a problem if him as a Muslim would do it too. I'm really all for balance and equality on this topic. And you know, that's really my two cents on this. Thanks for joining me for another episode. Definitely want to hear your thoughts and comments about this below. Hit that like button before you get on out of here, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one. Later.